Audi is in the middle of revamping its lineup for the 2020 model year. They're rolling out a new brand-wide design language, a revised naming scheme, and a few new models. All of this could be a bit much to take in. In this video, we'll make sense of everything. First, we'll touch on each car and see how they're different from one another. Then we'll see how the S and RS models differ from their base versions and end things off by deciphering Audi's naming scheme. Let's get started. The A3 is the smallest sedan in their lineup. In other markets, the car is available as both a hatchback and sedan, though it's only sold as the latter in the United States. The A3 sedan competes with the Mercedes Benz A-Class, the BMW 2 Series Gran Coupe, and other premium subcompact cars. It was last updated in 2017 and enters 2020 wearing an older version of Audi's design language. It sticks out when compared to the A4. A heavily updated version of the BMW 3 Series Fighter is due to reach American shores later this year. There are many exterior differences between it and the A3. Let's start with the headlight assembly. The A3 had a set of jewel-like bulbs housed inside of an angular DRL. The A4, on the other hand, puts a lot of emphasis on its hatched light signature. Moving up, we can see that the A4 has a gap between the grille and hood. The lower clips of both cars are a bit different as well. On the A4, the body bends upward to allow a splitter-like section to take shape. Conversely, the A3 foregoes the splitter altogether. There are more differences on the side. The A4 is longer, has a more defined boot, and lacks sandy chrome around the window. The A3's taillights are entirely under the joint line, while the ones in the A4 wrap around it. The A5 coupe should be easy to pick out from the others, as it's the only two-door, four-seat car in their range. Unfortunately, there is also a four-door variant of this. Let's compare it to the A4 since we're already familiar with it. Both cars have similar DRL patterns, but the A5 doesn't have the hood gap. The A5 also has detailing on the hood that frames the brand's rings. The character line comes out from the corner of the headlight and arcs over both wells. There are a few differences around the rear wheel. Firstly, the window on the A4 keeps straight, while the one on the A5 kicks up to create a unique pillar. There's a hatch directly underneath it that widens the car. Its two-door coupe origins are reflected in the fastback silhouette. The tail lights are more in line with the A3, but here the upper portion appears to pop out from the lower portion. The A5 Sportback looks great, though the sweeping roofline compromises both headroom and cargo space. The A6 is an option for those looking for a bit more practicality. It's Audi's entrant into the full-size luxury segment, which also includes the Lexus GS and BMW 5 Series. Its headlights are the biggest indicators up front. The housing design resembles the one from the A3, but the king at the bottom of the unit points outward. The DRL pattern separates the two. It goes straight across the unit and then scatters when it hits the blinkers. The A6 is the first car that we've seen with a flat, fleshed-out boot. Lastly, there's a chrome strip bisecting the taillights. The A7 is a four-door fastback, and shouldn't be confused with the A5 Sportback, Audi's other four-door fastback. It's slotted in a different but still pointless segment of Grand Coupes that includes the Mercedes-Benz CLS. The A7's front end actually has more in common with the A6. Both cars share the wider, more angular grille and headlight assembly, but the A7 borrows the hood styling from the A5. There are also similarities in their profiles. Where the A5 Sportback merely affixes another set of storage to the coupe, the A7 throws any sentiment of rationality to the wind and fully commits to its form factor. This means an aggressively sloped roofline, a true two-box architecture, and a smoother window kink. A few other Audi models have a light bar, but the A7's is unique in that there is more of a gradual flow from the main units to the bar. The A8 is the largest and most luxurious sedan in Audi's range. It does battle with the BMW 7 Series, Mercedes-Benz S-Class, and Jaguar XJ. This one is easily identifiable by the chrome strip that runs the entire side of the body. The A8 also has a toned-down LED signature and light bar. We've got their sedans and coupes out of the way. Now let's get to the crossovers and SUVs. The Q3 is the smallest crossover in their American lineup. It takes on the BMW X1, Mercedes-Benz GLA, Cadillac XT4, and other subcompact crossovers. It saw a redesign a few years ago and looks worlds apart from the compact Q5. The Q5 is positioned against the Acura RDX, Lexus RX, and BMW X3. It was last updated for the 2017 model year, and like the A3, still sports a version of Audi's old design language. It lacks the Q3's vertical grille strakes, kinked headlights, and three-dimensional rear LED signature. The Q7 that's currently on sale in the US bears resemblance to the Q5, but an updated version is on the horizon. It's positioned in the crowded midsize SUV segment that includes the Mercedes-Benz GLE, BMW X5, and Acura MDX. The updated model adopts design elements from the Q3, but there are a few slight differences. Its grille only has 6 sides compared to the Q3's 8, and the headlight kink is subdued. Around back, we can see that the Q7's lights take the light signature from the Q3 and the chrome trim from the A6. The Q8 breaks the mold established by all of their other cars. It competes in the emerging crossover coupe segment with the Porsche Cayenne Coupe and BMW X6. The front clip is dominated by an octagonal grille that both sinks into and peeks out from the body. The Q8's defining feature is the fastback roofline. This car also has a variant of the light bar. Here, the light bar is thin and frames the main units, which were arranged in a hatch pattern. All of this contrasts against a black housing. Lastly, the e-tron is Audi's first foray into the electric SUV segment. It blends into Audi's lineup pretty well despite the powertrain, though it does play with their design language a bit. The grille still has the strong vertical forks, but they're set in front of a shuttered pattern. The headlight kink gets smaller and smoother. There's also the horizontal metal trim that can be found on the body cladding on the side and rear. The TT is a two-seater sports car that is available as both a coupe and convertible. It competes with the BMW Z4 and Mercedes-Benz SLC. The R8 is positioned as Audi's halo car. It shares its platform and V10 engine with the Lamborghini Huracan. At a starting price of about $170,000, the R8 competes with cars such as the Porsche 911 Turbo and McLaren 570S. S models are a higher performance version of the base cars, though you probably wouldn't notice it at first glance. Up front, look for a red badge near the rings and additional chrome trim in the fog light housing. There's another edge badge at the rear, as well as a set of quad exhaust tips. This carries over to all their S cars and SUVs. RS cars are at the very top of the food chain. Audi communicates their sporting character through the absence of chrome. It's been removed from the grills, windows, and rear bumpers. The exhaust tips change once again. They swap the ones in the S models out for a set of ports large enough to put your fist through. Audi's naming scheme isn't quite as confusing as some other luxury brands, though it can still use some explaining. Let's take a name and go through what each part means. A3 Sedan S-Line Quattro Premium Plus 45 TFSI S-Tronic. A3 Sedan is the model. S-Line is basically an appearance package that lowers the car and adds a sportier body kit. Quattro indicates all-wheel drive. Premium Plus is the trim level. 45 TFSI tells us what engine the car has. The number reflects the power output of the car. It can range anywhere from 30 to 70. The example car has 45, meaning it makes between 226 and 248 horsepower. TFSI is short for Turbo Fuel Stratified Injection. At its most basic level, this means the engine is a direct injected forced induction unit. Lastly, S-Tronic is Audi's proprietary dual clutch transmission. Now we can use what we've learned to decipher a few more names. Q3 45 TFSI Quattro S-Line Prestige Tiptronic. The order isn't the same for every car, but the basic principles still apply. It's a Q3 that makes between 226 and 248 horsepower. It has all-wheel drive and is equipped with the S-Line appearance package. This particular model also has the top-of-the-line Prestige trim level. The Tiptronic is a more conventional automatic transmission. Let's do one more. S7 Sportback TFSI Quattro Prestige Tiptronic. This is an all-wheel drive S7 Sportback in the Prestige trim level with a Tiptronic automatic transmission. S and RS models also omit the horsepower designation in the name. It can be a challenge to make sense of Audi's cars and naming scheme. Hopefully, this guide has made navigating their lineup that much easier.